Don't cheat, man.
Take the opportunities that you give, make the most of them. Ultimately, don't sell yourself short. Be quicker, be faster. The world has way much more to offer than just your city. You gotta be selfish because it's for your own good. If you want something, and you really, first you gotta believe you can have it. If you believe you can have it and you want it, then you go get it.
The video shocking. Teenagers racing through a busy downtown Detroit.
On the streets of downtown Detroit Saturday night.
Police say it started when two Chevy Impalas started shooting into Al's Barbershop on Detroit's east side.
Inner city Detroit neighborhood is, that was the upbringing. The street I stayed on was Joy Road, so Joy Road is pretty heavy in like the, I guess you could say that if we were related to a gang, then Joy Road has its own territory like that. Drugs were common, but you sort of get used, sort of get adapted to it. So it's not really uncommon as you see it often. It just becomes a part of the neighborhood. A couple of the guys, you know, Rio, Keith, Denzel, you know, they all died. They all dead now to the gang. You know, they're involved in drugs or involved in people with drugs. And, died not too long after high school.
Some strength you just can't really measure with a mother, the strength of a mother, much stronger than a man.
Ain't that right?
I was 16, and I was young. I had no direction.
Single, four boys, I mean, working, that's a lot. Looking now, I have one child now, she had four by herself. That's a lot to take on, a lot of responsibility. So with that being itself, four boys, she's very strong for that.
I'm gonna tell you, when it was time to have you, I was expecting a girl. And I was like, oh, I got another boy. Dang. Not knowing that this boy was the one that would make me proud. Here I am having baby after baby after baby, and this man won't even pay the rent.
Yeah, what you marry this man for?
I am so ashamed that he is your father.
Really, I don't see how it's possible if a person truly believes or cares about their child or anything like that, how they would manage to stay away.
Yeah. You had a long day today? Your hair looking good. We're gonna grow this some more. I'm gonna get you some more hair growth.
This weather here got mood swings. It's better than snow. That's how I feel about it. God meant for basketball to be a huge part of my life in any direction, how I meet people or not, you know, but it's allowed me to meet a lot of people. I had a class in West Virginia at Glenville State, and it was a classmate, and it was a woman, she was my classmate. And she kept staring at it a couple times. But and one day she spoke to me. She said, hey, you play on the basketball team, right? And I said, yeah. She said, oh, good game yesterday. I was like, thanks. She happened to be from Vancouver, Canada.
And my wife, Tanya, they met and they became friends. So from time to time, I would go and visit her, seeing as that I lived here in Vancouver while she was attending school. and she was able to introduce us together.
She talked a lot about Vancouver's basketball, asked me if I ever was interested in playing basketball in Canada. And at the time, I didn't know nothing of any basketball in Canada.
Gabe was told us about the story of how he used up his eligibility and how he was going to, or had a disappointing career in his eyes. There might be the possibility that he could play basketball still in Canada.
He's a well-known basketball coach, you know, well-known basketball guy, you know, in the city. And it sounded very promising. You know, I was really convinced that if I was to come play basketball in Canada, it would be through them. I made sure to get my degree. I made sure if this school is going to pay for my tuition and everything like that, I'm going to get my degree out of it. After then, that's when he said, okay, here's the plan. We're going to fly you up. You're going to stay with us. You're going to stay for about a couple weeks. And I ain't never flew before. He said, ah, you'll be fine. Click. Just press the button. He said, okay, I'll send you the confirmation email. All right, talk to you later. Bye. And, you know, I'm shocked. I'm from Detroit. I ain't never flew. They allowed me to stay in their guest room in their house, you know, with their family and all of them. They fed me. They provided food and transportation. You know, they didn't ask for any dollar, any cent, you know, for me.
He had done a lot of good things the right way. It was really important for us that we help him see an opportunity through that he might not have had unless somebody helped him.
He drove me all around BC to see these colleges, you know, 10-hour drive here, you know, hour drive here, you know, I mean, just back and forth. And this is within 12 days, so it's just constantly driving, food, gas, you know, another kid on their hands, basically, another responsibility, and they were just so open to just helping me. Went back to Detroit, a good paying job, about $17 an hour, you know, in the office at a college institution. You know, I was the youngest in the office. So I was at a pretty good position at my work field, but I felt homesick from a place that I visited, which is contradicting. But ironically, it felt like home here. So ultimately, I think this is a home. I think I have a daughter here now. You know what I'm saying? So I basically started my family here.
He's very patient with Abriel, as in like. When she cries way too much, he actually takes the time to take care of that situation. Like, he doesn't give up, or like some other girl, they just kind of hand the baby to the mom and like say, take care of her. But with Gabriel, he actually takes the time taking care of her.
Yeah, I would like to call Vancouver home. It's a place I enjoy living here. You know, the people are great, the city is beautiful. You know, I am a globetrotter, I do like to travel, but whenever I'm not traveling, when I want to come back and lay my head, I want to lay it here.
Bryant turns and comes up short.
No, the buzzer!
What a test! Who took that bad shot?
Yeah, man, I met Gabe when I was in Vancouver a couple years ago. I was doing a Nancy Grace movie, and I needed a place to work out. And I tweeted, does anybody have a place to work out? Gabe hit me back amongst a couple other people, and he found me a gym. That's when he had dreads, and ever since then, we've been working out together. When I work out with somebody, if they can adapt, you know, and adjust to me quickly, I would like to work out with that person more. Gabe was one of the people that was able to adapt and adjust to how I work out. So then I later hired him to work out with me for the last couple years. And then when I leave him and we meet up again, he implements his own techniques, you know, his own strategies, and he adds that to my workouts. So he's actually becoming a really good trainer, a really good coach, and he's a really good player also.
When I work with Ron Artest, he revived the passion.
Met a brother. This is bittersweet, man. I don't know what to say.
Y'all took care of me over the years.
Dude, LA's gonna miss you, man.
I'll miss y'all too, man.
Yeah, I was praying to in church one time, and I knew I was gonna move to LA. I just knew it, and I told God, I said, if I'm supposed to move to LA, just send me a sign. You know, let me know if I'm supposed to make the move or whatever my next move is. Let me know. And that afternoon after church is when Meta texted me. He asked me, what was my plans for this summer? And I said, I'm just trying to find more work. And he said, I need a sports assistant. I said, okay, well, when you come to Vancouver, let me know. He said, no, I need you in LA. I mean, that can't get no more real than that. So that was a blessing. It was a prayer answer. It's funny, he'd just say things like, oh, we gotta go to New York. Or, oh yeah, we're going to Florida. Or he just said, yeah, we're going to China. We got to get ready for China. So he just say we. He always included me into it. So it was like, when he said, we're going to China, we got to get ready for China. I was like, oh, we got to go to China? Me? He's like, yeah, you got to get your visa and stuff. I was like, oh, all right, you know, cool. So he sort of just like, he just spoke it in. He didn't really ask anything like that. But he did ask after. He said, would I be cool to go to China? I said, yeah, man, let's do it. Even without Meta walking around, it was a lot of attention. Because first thing they say, oh, you basketball player? And I say, sometimes they speak English, sometimes they don't, you know, but I'd say, yeah, I play basketball, or I train. So a lot of pictures, a lot of kids, a lot of eyes, you know, they look at you like that, almost as if they've never seen, you know, either a tall person or a black person. I learned a lot from traveling. I learned a lot about culture. I actually learned more humbling manners, you know, how to humble myself, or I learned how to speak well, differently with different people that may not speak as much English, you know, so like traveling has allowed me to wear several hats and be comfortable in any one. Sometimes I do wonder, I'm like, man, should I even be accepting these trips? Or like, you know, does he really even need me, you know? I'm still Gabe Gibbs, but I'm just more of improved. I've tapped into more areas that Gabe didn't have prior to traveling. A lot of people have a lot of potential, but it's never maximized, and it could be due to untapped areas. I believe I can be one of the best trainers in the business. You know, with my skill set and my age and innovative thought patterns, with the right opportunities, taking advantage of them and presenting with them, I could be probably a highly considered trainer. I've changed a lot since Detroit. More relaxed, more calm, and at the same time, I do think this is a blessing. You know, it is a million people that could be in my position, but not a million people are blessed.
Don't.